The word of God says, as we are being quiet, the word of God says in Ecclesiastes chapter 3, to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven, time to born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. We are gathered here, beloved, to celebrate the life of Kenroy George Facy. As we celebrate his life today, we invite you to worship with us as we sing and pray and give tributes and reflect on memories. And this time I'm going to invite the congregation to assume an attitude of prayer as we pray. Let us pray. Most righteous God, We know in thy hands lies all power. And so as we come to this service, we are praying, God, that you may be with us. The family that mourn, we pray, God, that you may comfort them. We pray, oh God, that you may allow the righteousness of Jesus to be activated today. We're asking, God, in this solemn moment, as family members mourn the loss of this loved one, I pray, oh God, that you may keep all of us in perfect peace as our eyes are stayed on thee. We thank you for your blessing. We thank you for your grace. And we thank you for your mercies. In Jesus' name, let everybody say,
amen.
Amen and amen. At this time, we will turn to our program where we will sing the hymn that is listed in our program as we invite Leader Cunningham to lead out in this one.
Good morning, friends.
Good morning, people.
Good morning.
We are opening hymn. There were 90 and 9.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Eternal God and Father of mankind, here we are in your presence where there is fullness of joy. Father God, we give you thanks for this another opportunity to be in your house of praise. Father God, we bless your holy name. We praise you, we magnify you, we glorify you. Father God, we know that there is none like unto you. Father God, today we are in your presence, O God, where there is fullness of joy. But some of us, O God, are mourning, and you know the reason why. Father God, we ask that you comfort them and that you be with them. We ask, O God, that as we are about to go further into this service, your spirit will be here with us. Father God, we pray for every aspect. We pray for the one who is going to put forth your word, and that the words may not fall on the benches, but in the flesh table of our hearts. Hear us now, Lord, as we tell you thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
At this time, we invite Miss Victoria Grandison. She will be reading Revelation 21, 1 to 4.
Reading the scripture reading is taken from Revelation 21, reading from verse 1 to 4. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I saw John, saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down through God out of the heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacles of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from our eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things were passed away. May God add his blessing to the reading of his holy word.
This time we are going to invite Miss Marcia Stewart. Miss Marcia Stewart, she will be doing a solo for us here. Miss Stewart. And God answers prayer. He sees every
may be broken and feel battered, but your strength will surely come in the midst of all your heartaches. Your battle's already won. Just remember, in the hard times, don't give up, don't say you're done. Because God is the answer, and God. And he wipes them from me. I get down on my knees, and I'm the Savior. Help me, please. One thing is for certain, that God answers prayer. He sees every weakness, every trial, every man. And he wipes it from me. I get down on my knees, and I say, Savior, help me, please. One thing is for certain, the God answers prayer.
Praise the Lord. One thing for certain, God answers prayer. We can always come to Him because He's always answering our prayers. So we can always talk to Him because He's there. He promised never to leave us nor forsake us. So those of us who are mourning, remember, God is always here with us. At this time, scripture reading, Psalm 90, reading from verse 1 down to verse 6. This will be read by Ruth Facy.
Lord, thou hast been ordained in place in all generations. Before the mountain were brought forth, or if ever thou hast formed the earth. And the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turneth man into destruction and said, return, ye children of men. For 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night, thou carest them away. And with a flood, they are as asleep. In the morning, they are like grass which groweth up in the sixth and endeth. In the morning, it floodeth and groweth up, and in the evening, it is cut down and withered. This is the end of the Holy Word.
That's how it goes. We understand. At this time, we are going to make some changes to the program. On the program, there was no offering set up, so we are going to take an offering in aid of our church. So there are two containers here, and we are inviting you to come and put your offering in it, please. As we are about to sing some choruses, while you come forward. And after this, we'll be asking Sister Brenda to bless the offering for us, please. Oh, what a glory that will be.
Praise him above me.
giving God, eternal Father of creation. We act in your presence where there is fullness of joy, and at your right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Lord, we thank you for the many blessings that you have given unto us. We thank you for life, and we thank you for death. Because, Father God, in everything you said, we should give you thanks. And Father, as your children have stretched forth their hands to give a portion of what they have earned, I pray, divine God, that you will bless every pocket. You will bless every purse. Bless everybody, God Almighty, individually and collectively. And I pray, divine God, that as they give the monetary offering, that they will not only stretch forth to give with their hands, but Father God, they will give with their heart as a living sacrifice unto you. I pray, divine God, that the users of these gifts will use them wisely to enhance your kingdom here on earth as we continue to give you the glory and the honor. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Please remain standing as we are about to sing some choruses. Please remain standing.
You shall have a new
name in that land, in that land, that sunny, sunny land. We shall have a new name in that.
Thank you.
made a joint heir with Jesus, my Lord.
Please be seated.
Churched out, hurt and abused. About him and the Pawquit that I knew. Kenroy Jr.
George Facey was born September 27, 1984, the first son for his mother, Cherry Dixon, and the second son for his father. When he was about a year old, his mom came to live with our family in Montego Bay, close to the old railway train station. Some of the best years of my life was spent during that time period, me and Pocket. As an only child, all I ever wanted was a brother or a sister, and I got it. I remember when I would do something bad, and I'm coming home from school, and Pocket Lickle run up, on, you might have got beat you, you might have got beat you. And he told her we hide under house bottom. And then as soon as the train them come, he gone. Because from a young age, he was obsessed with vehicles. Obsessed with vehicles. Loved cars. Loved trains. He was destined to be a driver. As soon as Papa thought he could drive something, he would just tick off. That was the Papa I knew. He was loyal. He was loving and determined to be around vehicles. Oh, and he was very stylish and loved to dress. His brother Ralston Nelson also tells a story which tells us how much of a jokester he was. Every night, they didn't have chimney and a bedside. When Ralston chimney full up, Pop would move the chimney from under the bed, and when Ralston sleep bad, he'd turn over and he'd fall in the chimney. He was a jokester. That's what he did. That's the Pop that I knew. As he went on in life, he moved back to Warsaw. He lived with his great-grandmother, Miss Mumsy, and eventually with his father and stepmother, Jennifer Facey. While he was here, he attended Homewood High School, where he became a valuable member of the track team. He even qualified to run for Jamaica at the Penn Relays in the United States. He ended up driving and working for a Chinese-owned company in Falmouth, where he met the mother of his two daughters. One prior relationship produced his first and only son. Kenroy survived by his mother, Cherry, his father, Jim, his grandmother, Rosetta Gentles, his son, Kenique Facey, his daughters, Shernika and Sharnella Facey, his brothers, Ralston Nelson, Prince and Romaine Facey, his sisters, Stephanie, Renea, Ingrid, and Petra. And it wouldn't be a eulogy for this family if I didn't mention the grand aunts, Victoria Charmin, and also his brother, George, who predeceased him. So if I had achieved my chance to say goodbye, it would be difficult. It's difficult to say goodbye to someone who was so integral to my life for 36 years, someone I dearly loved. But even though my heart is throbbing with pain and tears are in my eyes, my head is filled with grief, I take consolation in the fact that I believe Kenroy is with God. And so I would tell him this. I would tell him, take those hands that you used to drive and put it in God's hands. And take the other hand and take the hand of the family members who went before you. Take Miss Mumsy's hand and walk with her. Take Miss Josie Hunt, Uncle Paul, Uncle Rupi, Sister Merle. Take their hand and say, I am glad to be home. Take their hands, too young to die, and tell them, I am here with you. Most importantly, tell God, thank you for us. Tell him that we are grateful. We are extremely happy and how lucky and privileged we were that you gave us 36 years with us. Kenroy George Facey, I know you're happy in heaven. I have you in my heart no matter how far. I will remember you every day. You were such a good person with so much to give. It makes it hard to say goodbye, but we will keep you in our hearts until we meet again in heaven. Take care. I love you.
Hello, good day everyone. Good day. Which afternoon are you, man? Good day, Steven. Sorry I'm late. Anyway, this is a message from one of Parker's brother Romain, as you all know. Alright, here it goes. Honestly, I don't know where to start. The truth is, I can't and I shouldn't be prepared to write a remember for Parker. I remember when he just came to live with us in Warsaw. I was about 6 and 7 years old. In my memory, served me correctly. He came with a difference. He was living in Montego Bay before. He was always a storyteller, telling stories about walking on the train line and stories about old man named Mr. Zapp. That was a family member. I was very lucky to have two older brothers growing up. I was scared of sleeping by myself or being in the dark. Parker was the one who would sleep beside. He was the kindest person with the spirit of most innocent child, always smiling, making jokes, very forgiving person. Even when he was sick with something as serious as a heart condition, he never allowed it to break his spirit. Bikes was still his favorite thing. We can never have a conversation without him adding something about bikes, always saying that he and I were once inherit riding skills from daddy, while adding that Prince is too coward to ride. Family was always important to him. The only time I can remember ever seeing my brother in rage is when someone or something possesses a threat to one of his family members. He would never be afraid to admit he was wrong. Also, he will stand for his right. You fought a good fight, my brother, and at the end I understand that you got tired and you took your rest. You will forever be missed. I am sorry I didn't get to tell you in my own words. I love you and I really appreciate you. Rest in peace, Parker.
There will be a floral tribute by the Facey family. We invite you to do so now. And following the floral tribute, this soloist, Miss Sherine Facey, will come with her solo, and then the sermon will be preached by Pastor Christoph Kleinmann.
What is it? Somewhere in the valley.
Lord, I question, Lord, why must this be? But he told me there is joy in my sorrows. Yes, and there is victory in its trials. Beside still waters, somewhere in the valley below, and he drew me aside to be tested and tried in the valley. He restored.
In the valley,
way down in the valley, he restores our soul. We serve a God who is a soul restorer, a burden bearer, a promise keeper, and a light in the darkness. In the valley, he restores our soul. Thank you, Miss Facy, for that song. A solemn reminder that God still restores souls in valleys. I wish I had a church in this place. I said, we serve a God who restores souls in the valley. In the valley, he restores my soul. I consider it a privilege to share in this funeral service with you. I take it humbly that I have been asked to share the message for today's funeral service. I know Parker. He would have been a more senior youth than I am. And he would always be known by his white smile. And the community has lost a gem, has lost a friend. The family has lost a son, lost a nephew, lost a grandson. You have lost a loved one. But I want to encourage you, like David would, saying that weeping will endure for the night. But praise be to God. Joy comes in the morning. Because in the valley, I wish I had a church in this place. In the valley, he restores my soul. I want to talk with you for a brief moment from the Word of God. The Word of God comes to us from the book of Revelation. Revelation chapter 21. And as the morning increases, I see this text as most fitting. The Word of God says, and I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth, Leader Cunningham, were passed away. And there were no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God, out of heaven, prepared as a bride, adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. I celebrate in verse 4. That says, and God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death. I wish I had a church in this place. There shall be no more death, and there shall be no more sorrow, no more crying, neither shall there be any. Away. I speak to you from the chapter today. No more. No more. Bow your heads with me as we pray. Father, I pray for the power of the Holy Ghost to be unleashed today. Pray, O God, that you may speak to me and speak through me. In Jesus' name we pray, let God's people say,
amen.
Amen and amen. I want to thank the minister of the Warsaw Baptist Church for allowing me the privilege to stand behind the sacred desk and the leaders and members of the church for accommodating us today in this funeral service. It is a blessing. It is a blessing to stand here and share God's word. But as we reflect on the text that was read earlier, in Revelation chapter 21, we see where God was speaking to John. I want you to just bear with me for a few moments. I promise you that I won't be long, so you can stay fastened, all right? I ask you to fasten your seatbelts for a little while, because I will not be long. John was in the spirit. John was receiving revelation from Almighty God. John, who would have been an apostle, who would have started and understood what it means to write in the book of Revelation. John, he being a man who was troubled on every side. John, being a man who had his own encounters with the Lord. John, after serving God for a very long time, he saw that he could do exploits for the Lord. So he began his ministry. Upon beginning John's ministry, John was seen as a heretic. He was seen as someone that needed to be punished. And you see, friend of God, as John was there preaching God's word, those of Rome believed that John was doing too much and was gaining too much traction. So they believed that it was now time for John to be removed from the face of the earth. So they came together and they arrested John. You see, what you see, Church of God, when God has a lead on your life, when God is in control of your life, no matter what the enemy tries, he's not, am I talking to the church? You see, John was having a challenge. He was being faced with persecution. He was being faced with challenges. But as John was faced with these, John rest assured in his heart that who God blessed, am I talking to the church? That John rest assured that who God bless, no man curse. I am praising God this morning. I don't know if I have a John in the house, but I want to let you know that if God bless you, no man can curse you. As long as you're right. Into a swimming pool. I said, oh, praise the name of the Lord. When God starts to work in your life, no matter what the enemy tries, I hear Paul says, if God be for you, who can be against you? No, it's getting a little warm in here, so let me just get into the word. I see, John was placed in the pot of burning oil, and when they saw that the pot going to kill John, they banished John to the island of Patmos. And when they banished him to the island of Patmos, they thought that they would have stopped him. But that kept John going, because it was on the island of Patmos that John got his revelation. And John says, as he looked through, as he looked down the corridors of time, I know that he would have been at his funeral service. John said, city. John said when he looked down the corridors of time, he see the new city. I don't know about you, but with all that is happening in our world, I can't wait until heaven becomes you, because you need to get to that holy city. But I want to let you know that if you decide to go to the city, you can't go anyhow. I know that some people might stop praising God now and might stop shouting now, but I'm going to talk to somebody to let them know that you can't go to heaven as you like. You can walk as you like. You can talk as you like. But you can't. Some people would want to live anyhow. They want to do anything and expect to go to the kingdom of God. I have news for you. I said news flash. It's not any and anybody can step into the kingdom of God. You have to be born again. Holy Ghost filled. You have to baptize and have Jesus on your mind. So some people take heaven for a plaything. So they have one foot in and one foot out. They pan the river and pan the back. When it comes out to the word of God, when it comes out to heaven, it's not on the river or on the bank. You're either for God or against God. You're either for God or you're against God. And so today, I want to warn somebody. I said, get your soul in the right stand with the Lord. Amen. Then it says, John said when he saw the city coming down, he noticed something else. He noticed that in the city, the people there were not crying. Am I talking to the church? The Bible says, and God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. The Bible says that God shall, I love this word shall in the text. It says, and God shall wipe away all tears from our eyes. I know that there are those who come here today would love to see in Papa to have been alive so that they can have another laugh. But you're crying today, and the word come to tell you today that weeping won't last always. The message today is that God shall wipe away all tears.
Amen.
From the earth. I said, there's coming a day when death shall die. There's coming a day when sickness will be no more. There'll be no more heart problems. There'll be no more cancer. There'll be no more COVID. The Bible says, for all these things will be passed away. I bless the name of the Lord that there's coming a day when my God will wipe. From our eyes. The Bible says that when all these things are passed away, that when we will see all these things passed away, the glorious appearing of our Lord will be closer than we first believe. I want to say to the church of God today that God is coming back. And the Bible says that He's coming and He will not. He said, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, and I will pay every man according to his work. So everybody is going to get their salary. The fornicator will get the fornicator's salary. The adulterer will get the adulterer's salary. The homosexual will get the homosexual salary. But as for the child of God, those who are blood-washed, there's no need to worry, because you're calling. An election can be sure. When you are born again, the Bible says in Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall. Oh, praise the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Oh yes, I praise God that the Lord is still a shepherd to us. I praise the name of the Lord that the Lord is still a shepherd. And then he goes down in the fourth verse to say that because I am your shepherd, yea, though you walk through the valley, oh praise the name of the Lord, yea, though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you will fear no evil because God is with you. And then the last verse says,
it's not
you're empty. But I want to tell you that weeping will not last always. So continue to trust in God. Trust in God. And He will supply your needs according to His riches in glory. Trust God. Trust God. And you shall live. God bless you.
What a word, Madam God, Pastor Hyman, what a most strong words of here. We thank God for you, and we will continue to pray God's word for you. At this time, we invite the Facy family, Stephanie Gordon, Donna Brandis, and Shevar Blair to the remarks here. One at a time. Stacy family.
Disappeared, and it was just them and their dad. You could feel and love the bond they shared with each other. My brother had many goals. But one of his major goals was to buy a car to drive our mom around Jamaica so she could see and experience her homeland and to get one of her favorite food, ice cream. If you ever had the opportunity to be around my brother, you could feel his energy. He could put a smile on your face upon the first impression with him. I remember one day, the beginning of this year, Kenry called me and said, "Steffi, this is the year that everything will change." I said to him, "Are you going to get better?" He didn't answer the question. On January 11th, I remember getting the call that my brother had passed, but I knew in that moment he was free from all his pain and suffering. My brother was blessed to have met some really great people who have treated him with so much love that he... My brother was blessed to have met some really great people who have treated him with so much love and respect a few months ago. It could be as early as 6 a.m. in the morning, and they would be there to take him to the hospital. I want to acknowledge them and say a big thank you. It means a lot to me, but it means a lot more to my mom. My two favorite memories with my brother was taking my family to Little Ochi to get seafood. I can't lie, the food was good. And it was one of my favorite moments with my family. My other favorite moment was driving to Trelawney to surprise my grandma with my mom. We had the best stock and food on the road. He stopped in Falmouth to show me his work at the stadium. I know that you are physically gone from this world and you are no longer there. To watch your children grow up, but there's a sense of peace knowing that we have gained an amazing angel to watch over us, because I know there's nothing in this world can to the amount of love you have for your children, family, and parents. Until we meet again, I love you, Big Ed, forever and always.
Everyone, including myself. Not in my wildest dream, I knew I would be standing here to say something on behalf of my nephew. But to God be the glory, He's at peace and He's at rest. On January 7, when I spoke with my nephew, never did I imagine it would be the last conversation. Kenroy was full of life. Even in his dying days, he would spoke with passion and enthusiasm because he always believed he would get better. Unfortunately, he was called home too soon. Kenroy, you were the light in the room. Your energy would brighten the room. And your smile would bring us joy. A person who loved everyone. You were the first to reach out. A person everyone loved. You were the first one to reach out to check on family. Whether it was a phone call or a text message, you always check in to make sure everyone was doing well. I remember the day my son got married. He came up to me after my speech saying, "Oh, you love Christ so much. Stop crying, man. Today is a happy day." Kenroy, words cannot express how much I miss you. And although I'm sad, I find comfort in knowing that you are in pain no more. Your parents, Sharon and Jim, and to your children, I offer my deepest condolences. No parent should have to bury a child. May you find comfort in knowing that you are raised an amazing man, and that all will remember forever. Rest in peace, Parkwet.
Myself today, not feeling sad. I was surprised how calm I was, actually. This is the first time I've been to Jamaica since I've left, where my cousin's not here. Every time, everywhere, no matter where I was at, he was always next to me. He always had my back. I remember when we were growing up, we were in Montego Bay. We were about 8, and we were working at the milk factory, unloading the milk truck.
Yep.
And Paco was the first one to say, "Triella, milk truck there, gotta go get the money." That was him, ambitious. From ever since, he always had some kind of hustle. He was always working, and he was always steadfast. You could always count on him. No matter the situation, he was always there. He would find time, and he would make sure that he'd take care of you. I'm gonna say something quickly. My cousin, he was not only a man of character, but he had a lot of integrity, and he was very prideful. He didn't want help, but he knew when he needed it. He would try his hardest. He worked his hardest. And I will always honor and respect him for the man that he was. He left behind a legacy that is unmatched. We would work daily to remember you and to honor you. The good book reminds us that blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Kenroy, may your soul rest peacefully, and may your friends and family find comfort in your memories. For death leaves a heartache no one can heal, but love leaves a memory no one can steal. We will always love and honor you. My cousin, my friend, may God bless your soul. Amen.
Let us pray. I'd like you to stand as we pray. Let us pray. Father, as we close this service today, we know that this is not the final for the family. There are days when their eyes will get wet, when memories go around in their minds. But even though, God, we are commending them to your love, that you may keep and care for everyone. Be with Parfait's grandmother, his mother, his father, his relatives. I pray, God, that you may be with his brothers and sisters. I pray that you may be with his cousin. For those whom he left a mark, an indelible mark on their life, I pray, God, that you may comfort their weary heart even now. And we pray, oh God, that days ahead, when they cry because of memories, we pray that that cry will turn into laughter because of your goodness toward them. We pray, oh God, that you may never leave them nor forsake them. We pray that even this family may come to grips of the reality, Lord, that it is appointed unto man who wants to die, and after death comes the judgment. I pray that all will be faithful until that day. God, we're asking you for your blessing. We're asking you for your mercies and your grace. In Jesus' name we pray, that God's people say,
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We say, may the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the full fellowship of the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, rest, remain, and abide us all, both now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. As we prepare to sing the recessional hymn.
Our recessional hymn shall be Gather at the River.
Thank you. I took for granted when to hear your voice was just a call away. Oh, what I'd give for just some time to say the things that slip my mind. There's so much now I'd really like to say. But I can never go back when we did the things we did back then. I'll store those precious memories in my mind. I'll take what you've instilled in me. I'll try to be all I can be and walk the path that you have left behind. I sure miss you. Life will never be the same with you not here. Each passing day has brought much pain, but with God's grace my strength remains. I sure miss you. Heaven's sweeter with you there. now like gold in a memory vault. I cherish every one I have of you. Now I can see and recognize the part you played to shape my life. Often see you in the things I do. In God's design and master plan, He saw the hurting hearts of man as we would say goodbye to those so near. So with our family and friends, we'll be together once again. We'll view heaven's splendor hand in hand. I sure miss you. Life will never be the same with you not here. Each passing day has brought much pain. With God's grace, my strength remains. I sure miss you. The heaven's sweeter with you there.
I took the supermarket flyers from the windowsill. I threw the day-old tea from the cup. Packed up the photo album Matthew had made. Memories of a life that's been loved. Took the Garrett Wilson car.
Read. because I see him good time.
You were an angel in the shape of my mom. When I fell down, you'd be there holding me up. Spread your wings as you go.
Okay, we're past it. Right.
Oh, sorry.
Turn it.
Oh, God, take it.
Can you put this here for me?
Excuse me? Sir, can I?
I'm telling them. He's just explaining.
I did something you put in here.
Wait, did it come already?
No.
When it come, you want me to do it or no? No? Right now? The one now?
Yeah, the one we did something you put in there.
That's fine,
Danny. You're facing it.
You have a car?
Yes, right.
God takes you back, he'll say hallelujah, said he'd drive, then put his hand on my cheek and wiped a tear from the side of my
If you want to zoom, you zoom it here and then you press this to take it.
Oh, Robert, I come here.
No, don't, not that one. The one at the front right here. This one, zoom it. You can move it left or right and zoom it. And then that's the one up above it. Take the picture. Yeah.
Here it is, Jim.
Put that seat there.
Thank you very much.
No, turn it first.
Ricky Pasca.
Come on, your time now.
What's your
okay, turn right. Okay. I'll agree with you.
As we close the casket, we invite all that are here today to help us to sing the song that is in our program. Shall we gather at the river where bright angels' feet have trod? Yes.
Push it halfway for me.
Halfway.
Right to here.
Help me with singing that song. Shall we gather at the river?
Shall we gather
at the river where bright angels sweet have trod, with the spirits that died for us flowing from the throat. Come on, everybody, sing.
Yes, we will gather at the river.
The beautiful,
beautiful
river. Gather with the saints.
Gather with the saints of the river.
enthroned by the throne of God.
On the margin of the river.
On the margin of the river.
King of his silver spray. We shall walk and worship ever.
We shall walk and worship ever.
All the happy golden day.
Happy golden day.
Yes.
Yes, we will gather at the river.
The beautiful.
Beautiful, beautiful river.
Gather.
Gather with the saints of the river. By the throne.
Here we reach the shining river.
Here we reach the shining river.
Lay we every burden down.
Lay we every burden down.
Grace our spirit will deliver.
Grace our spirit will deliver.
And sing the song, everybody.
Yes, we will gather at the river.
A beautiful, beautiful, beautiful
river.
Gather with the saints.
Gather with the saints of the river that flows by the throne of God.
Soon we'll reach the silver river.
Soon we'll reach the silver river.
Soon our pilgrimage will cease.
Soon our pilgrim heaven
sees. Soon our happy hearts will quiver.
Soon our happy hearts will quiver.
With a melody of peace.
With a melody of peace.
Sing everybody, yes.
Yes, we will gather at the river.
No.
Beautiful, beautiful river.
Gather.
Gather with the saints of the river that flows by the throne of God.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray, Father, as we commence this burial service, we pray for your guidance in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. The word of God says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 13, but I would not have you ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that he sorrow not even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will we bring with them. For this we say unto you, the word of the Lord, that which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent with them which are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend with a shout from heaven, with the voice of the archangel and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Dearly beloved, as we are gathered here to lay to rest the life of Mr. Kenroy George Facy, we tenderly commit his body to the earth, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, remembering as we do in the sure and certain hope of a joyful resurrection. As our workmen prepare to work, we will continue with singing some choruses. I'm not seeing them listening in our program. We're going to sing the first. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal break and fear, when the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Just help me with singing that one, the singers in the place.
Any more eats you want to go and eat?
The trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be.
Any more eats you want to go
and eat? And the morning grace eternal bright and fair. Sing! And the roll? When the roll!
When the roll!
When the road is gone up yonder,
when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
On that bright and cloudless morning.
And the glory of the resurrection when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
The last and the now, let us labor.
Let us labor for the Master from the Lord you sent his Son. Let us talk of all his wonders, love and care.
Sing again.
And when the call of honor is over and the work on earth is done.
And the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Sing everybody, when the
roll is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
One more time, when the roll
is called up yonder. When the roll
is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Amen.
Amen.
Some sweet day. I'm going away.
Some sweet day. I'm going away. I'm gonna leave this world. No more to roam.
Sing everybody.
Some sweet day.
By and by.
high and high. Sing everybody.
You walk the street of glory by and by.
You're gonna walk the street of glory. You're gonna sing redemption story. You're gonna walk the street of glory by and by.
By and by, by and by.
When the morning comes, when all the saints of God shall gather around, He will tell the story of the Lord come. We will understand.
Spark with you, rest in hope. You hear, sir?
Yeah, man. No, great. You can raise it for
me. Oh, I don't
know
how to do it.
You can hold my body down. No grave can hold my body down.
No grave can hold my body down.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise, no grave can hold my body down.
Oh, no grave,
no grave
can hold my body down.
Oh, 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 oh.
No grave can hold my body down. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise, no grave
can hold my body down.
Oh, no
grave
can hold my body down.
No grave can hold my body down.
Thank you.
Ich war
All right, bow your heads with me as we do the benediction. May the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the full fellowship of the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, rest, remain, and abide with us all, both now and forevermore. Amen. And amen. Amen. God bless you, everybody.
God bless you, too.
There is refreshment at this right out there. The family would like to thank everyone for their love and support. Your cards, your prayers, and words of encouragement are greatly appreciated during our time of grief. Thank you, and may God continue to bless you. Goodbye, everybody.
Over here.
Can I have one?
Oh, yes,
son.
Yes.
Fire.
So how many
sons I have?
Something
you could readjust so that. I'll just step back over here. Come this side. Go back to the tree. Come this side.
Oh, you're not here, no one.
Somebody can see this camera over here?
Nobody move, nobody get hurt.
Right. Open up with a smile. Alright. Remove the mask.
I don't remember hearing it.
Next. Alright, with a smile. Don't move like that. Alright, line up that
mouth. We have an addition.
All right.
Come on, call it, go up front. Go up front, Yeah, you go. Go faster. Yeah, there you go.
Tom.
Any more
people?
He's supervising,
that's
always.
All right, ready for this? I'm just coming over here. Canada shots. Any pretty? Don't move.
Don't move.
Well, tell somebody something who's not here.
Who's not here?
Yeah. Then disconnect. Some family member.
I'll say something. Hi, Ruth and AJ. I'm sorry you guys are not here today. I miss you. You missed it. Love you all. It was a great service. That was a great service. Thank you. Thank you, each and every one. Thank you, everyone, for attending. Parker, you're gone, but you will always remember. And remember to be your angel.
Parker, I am so glad you're no longer in pain. Be safe. Rest in peace.
Yeah.
She's cute though. Sorry.
Turn around and touch the reach. Turn around and touch the reach. The reach.
Put your hand on top of it.
Turn it back
to this side.
Yes. Right where you are. Right. Yeah. All right, look on the camera and push the reach. Kind of bend down and push the reach, like you have put on the reach. Like how you put it down. No, turn side turn like you have put on the reach.
Stoop down.
Like it's
all right, done. Push the reach down. Yeah. Thank you.
Come on, Shabba.
Yeah, remember. Come on, Shabba. 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 Come on,
How do that? Don't know one. Can I get
a picture with you?
No, no, you know.
I have to go down there and put out so that I can move at the same time. So we can have this tomorrow.
All right.